students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding rights for the rightful owners written by Brinda Karath. Now this editorial basically deals with the rights of the tribals. This editorial also deals with the issues of environment conservation, environment protection and the welfare of the other traditional dwellers in the forest areas. Now, in order to understand the relationship of the tribals with the forests and the relationship of the government with the forests and the relationship of government with the tribals, we need to understand what has been the history of this entire issue. Now, as far as forests are concerned, they are a very resourceful resource. The forests, they have embedded in themselves billions and millions of tons of metallic and non-metallic resources. Forests, they have embedded in themselves the resources in terms of forest wood, resources in terms of various types of plants that have a therapeutic value. So forests in themselves is a bountiful resource. Now, because it is a bountiful resource, there had always been an eye of the government to usurp these resources. There had always been an eye of the corporate class to usurp these resources. So various types of corporate interests, various types of governmental interests, and in the pre-independence era, the imperialistic interests, they had been playing an important role in usurping these forest resources. Now, Britishers, in order to have access to the forest resources, they'd passed an act. And the name of the act was Indian Forest Act 1923. Now, at the phase of this act was passed in order to conserve the forest resources, in order to preserve the forest resources. But the basic cause of passing this act, that is Indian Forest Act 1923, was to usurp the forest resources, was to nationalize the entire forest resources. So the government had a direct relationship of usurpation of the forest resources. So the key word here is usurpation. And another key word in this entire episode is the disregard, is the indifference towards the tribal dwellers. No concern was basically shown to the livelihood of the forest dwellers. Their rights were neglected, their rights were negated, their rights were not taken into consideration. So a direct relationship was maintained between the government and the forests. And this entire relationship has sustained till 2006. Even in independence era, government had not institutionalized a mechanism whereby the rights were conferred onto the tribal dwellers. So the rights were never conferred onto the tribal dwellers till 2006. Even Wildlife Protection Act 1972, this is a legislation that was passed in independent era. But this legislation also provides for the bureaucratic set up with respect to the forest resources. It was the bureaucracy that was to decide about what rights should be conferred to the forest dwellers. Now, why it is important to confer rights to the forest dwellers? It is important in the name of the human rights. It is important in the name of preserving and conserving the environment. Now, if the rights will not be conferred to the forest dwellers, it will lead to the plundering of the forest resources. Now, who will plunder these forest resources? These forest resources will be plundered by the corporate class. Now, how will they be plundering these forest resources? They will be extracting the resources in the form of mining. They will be extracting the wood by resorting to deforestation. So it is important not only for the preservation of the human rights, but also the preservation of the nature, for the preservation of the biodiversity, for the preservation of the ecology. It is also important to thwart, to stop over anthropocentrism. It is important that the man should not be exerting overtly over these forest resources. Now, in 2006, a watershed legislation, a transcendental legislation was passed. And what is the name of this legislation? It's the Forest Rights Act. It is the tribals and the other traditional forest dwellers act. And what this act says, this act says that the tribal population and the other traditional forest dwellers, the other traditional forest dwellers means like the poor people, like the communities belonging to the lower strata, social lower strata of the society. Now, what is meant by social lower strata? It means specifically the Dalits. Now, if the Dalits, they are residing in these forest areas, they should be given the right to cultivate the forest land. They should be given the right to use the minor forest products. The keyword is minor forest products here. So basically, this Forest Rights Act in 2006, very, very important period, 2006, with respect to the tribal rights. So after 2006, certain rights were conferred on to the forest dwellers. And another, this legislation is also a big, has also brought a big change. A change from the bureaucratic form of administration to the participative form of administration. Now, how this has brought about a transition? Now, before 2006, we had a system whereby the bureaucracy was deciding about how the forest rights should be conferred on to the people. लोगों जो भी ट्राइबल्स हैं उनको कितना अधिकार देना चाहिए ये एक ब्यूरोक्रेट डिसाइड करता था 2006 के बाद ये अधिकार लोगों को दे दिया गया है इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ग्राम सभा कंसेंट ऑफ द ग्राम सभा इट इज द ग्राम सभा दैट विल बी डिसाइडिंग अबाउट हु आर द ट्रेडिशनल फॉरेस्ट ड्वेलर्स इट इज द ग्राम सभा हु विल बी डिसाइडिंग अबाउट द राइट्स ऑफ द ट्राइबल्स It is the Gram Sabha who will be deciding about should the land be given away for the developmental purposes or not. So this legislation has brought about a transcendental, a phenomenal, a substantive change. How the rights of the tribals should be protected. But of late, as far as this editorial is concerned, but of late, there has been an aberration. There has been a change. Now, what is this change? First of all, the government is trying to dilute the legislation. Now, how the government is trying to dilute the legislation? Government is trying to do away with the consent of the Gram Sabha. Now, how government is doing this in reality? Government is doing this in reality by adding certain sub-clauses to the Forest Rights Act. Government has added an exception. The keyword is exception here. The government has added an exception that the consent will not be mandatory if the land is taken away from a small coal bed area. If a land is taken away for the developmental purpose, moreover, more exceptions has been added to the spires legislation, that is Forest Rights Act, in the form of, like, government has come out with numerous forest legislations in the form of Mine and Mineral Development and Regulation Bill. Now in this MMDR bill, it is not important, it is not necessary for the government to take permission from the Gram Sabha. So a dilution has been added. Then you have got compensatory afforestation management and planning authority. You have added another authority, but you have added n number of exceptions in the functioning of this authority with respect to the forest areas, how the forest areas should be actually used. So government, first of all, at the central level is trying to dilute this legislation. At the second level, it is the state governments. Now the state governments of Jharkhand, the state governments of Maharashtra, state governments of Andhra Pradesh, the state government of Telangana. Now these state governments, they are coming up with exceptions. They are trying to add exceptions to this Forest Rights Act 2006. And at the third level, another conspiracy is going on. Now what is this conspiracy? This conspiracy is again the intrusion of the bureaucracy with respect to the government, with respect to the forest rights, and with respect to the traditional forest dwellers. It is the bureaucracy that has again begin to play a role in deciding about who is a traditional forest dweller, who is a tribal, should a particular tribal have an access to a piece of land or not, generally called as patta. Now what is meant by patta? Patta means a land written in someone's name. Now it is the bureaucracy who is deciding about whether a person is a traditional forest dweller or not. So there has been cases of rejection of ownership, rejection of dwelling the forest areas. Now government, it is coming out with the use of the force in order to expel the people, expel the tribals who have failed to prove their homeland as the forests. Government is intruding. Government is calling this entire episode as a law and order problem for the people who have failed to prove that they are the traditional forest dwellers. So basically, what, in which direction we are moving? Basically, we are moving to the pre-colonial era, or the colonial era, where the rights of the forest dwellers were not protected, where the forest was just seen as a bountiful resource, where the government had tried to nationalize the forest, where the government had tried to negate the forest. So something positive that was introduced by this Forest Rights Act, the government is trying to dilute it with exceptions, with added rules and regulations, and by enacting supplementary acts. Now for more, you can just read the brainy map on this editorial on our website brainyias.com. For more, you can also read the note on this entire editorial. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.